Hi, this is Dr. Usha, working at practicing at Partha Dental, Ramurthy Nagar branch, Bangalore. Today, my topic is about oral manifestation in COVID patient and its treatment and prevention. First, we'll come to know the oral manifestation in the COVID patients. The mechanism of the COVID infection is that there'll be a cellular destruction due to viral invasion or the consequences of the host immune reaction to the viral antigen. The oral manifestation in the COVID patients is that there'll be an ulceration, erosions and lesions, and there'll be a deep papillated tongue, there'll be an halitosis, there'll be a swelling of the gums and tongue, and there'll be an whitish discoloration, there'll be an angular cheilitis at the corner of the tongue, and there'll be an atypical taste, that is, there is a loss of taste after some 10 days or 14 days, and there'll be a loss of smell. These are the oral manifestations seen in the COVID patients. And the most common site is the labial mucosa, the tongue and the palate region. And the more the females and the males both are affected, and the persons who are prone for diabetes mellitus, hypertension, and they are more and old people, they are more prone for COVID infections. And the predisposing factors in the COVID infections includes there'll not be a proper maintenance of the oral hygiene, there'll be a plaque and calculus on the teeth, and because of not properly maintaining the oral hygiene, they start developing the throat infection, and they'll start getting the COVID infections. And due to the lack of the oral hygiene, and opportunistic infections start even there'll be an immunosuppression, and because of diabetes mellitus and immunosuppressive drugs, they'll start there'll be a fungal growth and all everything, and there'll be an vasculitis and hyperinflammation response will be seen, and there'll be a severe in COVID patients. So these are the oral manifestations in the COVID patients, and the oral health tips what I give to avoid the COVID and reinfection is first you have to get vaccinated. The vaccination decreases the severity of the disease and it prevents from ICU. You have to not do the shopping of the vaccination. Example I give you is whenever you go to a mobile shop, and when you choose, there'll be a different brands of mobiles. Like you'll get Apple, Motorola, and Nokia, etc. But all the features will be same. So in case of vaccination, the brands will be different, but the features, everything will be same, and that it reduces the severity of infection for you. And there'll you'll get COVID, but there will not be an ICU admission at all. So all the age groups, it's better to get vaccinated, and according to the government protocols. And if you get vaccinated, it is the disease progression and severity will be reduced, and there'll be less lesions in the CT scans. So it will be the severity will be avoided for you. And after the COVID infection, you have to replace your toothbrush. That is, the change your toothbrush after COVID infection, as it the COVID virus, that is, the some of the remnants can be harbored in the toothbrush bristles. So that when you replace the brush, it will be the COVID remnants can be avoided. So the chances of reinfection might be avoided. So you have to replace your toothbrush after the COVID infection. And you have to use your new toothbrush, and you have to maintain proper oral hygiene by proper toothbrushing, scaling, cleaning. Whenever you decrease the load of bacteria in your mouth, and there will not be much of the throat infection, and you'll not be prone for infections. And you have to do properly hot water. You have to drink hot water, and you have to do salt water gargle, betadine gargle. And betadine gargle is the mouthwash is effective against the COVID virus. So you have to regularly use mouthwash, because they have done studies that the betadine mouth gargle reduces the COVID virus infection. There are many studies on betadine. So you have to regularly use your betadine mouthwash to prevent the COVID infection. And you have to use the salt water gargle to avoid the throat infection. washing. Change your mouth mask when it gets unusual smell from it, and you'll be having it harbors many of the bacteria and viruses. So after every 4 to 5 use, you have to change your mouth mask, and you have to maintain proper hygiene, and you have to the proper social distance and all should be followed. And the poor oral hygiene is prone for COVID infection, so maintain your oral hygiene properly by brushing your tooth daily, twice daily, that is morning and night, and properly using your mouthwash can reduce the risk of COVID infection. And the oral fungus growth candida can be avoided by properly maintaining your oral hygiene. So the fungus can be avoided. And the population with the oral health and chronic disease disparities, COVID-19 puts both at the COVID increased risk of COVID. So COVID patient with loss of taste and smell, that is regular use of tongue cleaner as it helps in recovery of the taste buds in COVID patients. It takes 2 weeks for the recovery of the taste and smell, as there will be a toxins that is the there'll be because of the COVID patients, there'll be a cellular death in the tongue, and due to keratinization, and there'll be a slough production on the openings of the taste buds, so you'll not find the perception of the taste. So perception of the taste will not be found. So when you start using the tongue cleaner after COVID infection, there'll be removal of the slough from the opening of the taste buds, and so you can have the perception of the taste as soon as possible. So you have to regularly use your tongue cleaner after the COVID infections. And nowadays the most common common topic is rising the post COVID mucormycosis in the oral cavity as well, that is the mucormycosis. Don't ignore the symptoms. That is the oral manifestation of mucormycosis includes there'll be a tooth pain that is in all the teeth, and there will be a nasal discharge which is somewhat like blackish discoloration, and there'll be a pus discharge from all the region of the gums, which is generalized and which is not localized, mainly the maxillary region, and you will be having the blacking in the palate region, and there'll be a salty taste in the mouth due to production of the fungal remnants, and you have to consult the doctor or a dentist immediately. And the other symptoms of the mucormycosis involves there is a nasal blockade, and there is a congestion or the nasal discharge. The local pain on the cheek bone will be present, and one-sided facial pain or numbness will be present, and there'll be a redness and protrusion of the eye, and there'll be a swelling of your eye will be present, and there'll be a blackish discoloration over the nose region and the palate region, and will be discharged from your nose also. And coming to the oral cavity, there'll be a loosening of all your teeth, and it will be localized, or it will be a total generalized loosening of your teeth, and a whole jaw involvement will be present, and there'll be a blurred or double vision with the plane will be present, and there'll be a necrosis or skin lesions, and you'll be finding the chest pain, and you'll be having the skin lesions, and pleural effusion will be there, and there'll be a worsening of respiratory symptoms. So this mucormycosis can be avoided by properly maintaining your oral hygiene. That is, you have to maintain your oral hygiene by scaling, by properly tooth brushing, by using proper mouthwashes and proper tongue cleaning. By properly maintaining your oral cavity, you can avoid this mucormycosis of the oral cavity, that is the fungus growth in the oral cavity. And the prevention is maintained, you have to maintain the proper oral hygiene and the body hygiene, that is, you have to not use others you have to maintain your house and in a proper hygiene and all everything. And other thing is, you have to control your diabetes mellitus. Because of diabetes mellitus, there'll be an opportunistic infections like this fungal growth in your mouth and the nasal region, the sinus region, and everywhere it starts spreading whole of your body. So when it spreads whole of your body, there'll be a very difficult in managing. If it is little spread has happened, then you can do the surgery of the you can sinus surgery and you can remove the fungus and all, and you can do eye surgery and all. Later, if it more of the eye is involved, then you have to remove your eye and all. There is no other option. So prevention is better cure in the case of your mucormycosis, and you have to control as much as the diabetes mellitus and limited use of steroids. That is, judicious use of steroids is the ultimate in the prevention of mucormycosis. And thank you for listening my topic, and stay safe, stay healthy, and let's fight together, fight for India, and we all will recover from COVID. Thank you.